The T is true, the I is internal, and the S is self. All render true internal self. Art is.
They had a surround.
They lived in these different cities. They drilled in these different places. And what their attitudes was about were and how and when they lived and how their lifestyles were or what was around that lifestyle. Either I could have took which wristwatches, the watches, some company could have gave me watches. And I would have called it time running down on you. Because whatever you put up there, you could hear it running down, you see. But in the concept of that coming down, it made me think of what? The grains of sand and an hour that always came down. We never saw one goes up. It took skill to do that. And what you all call skill and precision, then you say that's an art. They did it with an art. They cooked it with an art, a skill. They danced with an art. They made an art of it. The way that they presented it, it became an art. But practice, they practiced it over and over and over again. So to every doctor, a doctor and a nurse, they are artists. They are artists acting out what they do. And they do it well because they are more than what would we call art. They are more than the Hollywoods. Mm-hmm. And they are more than the Broadways. Because their plays is for real, each and every 24/7 of our times. I think nature as a background is beautiful as well as just taking it out of that form and saying, let's look at it now in a researchable manner. I think exhibit places and galleries is places where things are brought to research, where people are searching and to understand the evidence and the contents thereof, where you take our lightning, the piece that I did, and the front of lightning right there. I didn't show the lightning rod. I just showed the front of lightning. So that became more powerful for me when I saw that little piece there. But if you turn that piece upside down, then I would have to rename the piece that's on the pedestal behind me. Yeah. But the whole thing is to see how I used it in a concept of a two-way perspective. Because if you turn it upside down, then that piece would kind of be holding up a piece of wood that almost looked like it's in the form of a human body. And then if you sit that up, it actually goes back to maybe even surpass the Nubian period in Africa of the burial ways of Africans surpassed the Egyptian manner. Egypt has always been Egypt because that's the name of a place. But the manner of Egypt has not always remained the same. That's the big mistake we make. When we think of Egypt, ooh, that's the place of the pyramids. That's the place of the Valley of the Kings and the Valley of the Queens. But the periods of the kings and the periods of the queens, it's what's missing. So if you look at that piece, it may carry way back to the earliest, actually travelers traveling up from the depths of Africa, bringing these bodies up to the burial ground. It's like this is a royal cemetery. So King now, down in the Congo, or either down by Ethiopia or somewhere like that, everybody wanted to carry this head, King, to the burial grounds of kings and queens. So you can see them loading them on whatever transportation manner they had. 9 times out of 10, it was elephants way back then. Elephants did a whole lot of the really, really rough terrain travel.
Animals come to the
house. So that's the reason why I really love the concept. Space Shuttles.
Space Shuttles. And 144,000 elephants. Divide them by six. And every 60 hours, let one leave the earth from here, and another one leave the earth from there, and another one leave the